Hey everyone, today's video is going to be on my first year college experience studying computer science at Drexel. So I'm going to start by talking about why I chose to study computer science. So I've always been interested in technology, since the past few years. And I've also had a few app and website ideas that I could never execute because I didn't know how to code, and to get it made by someone else would be really expensive. So that's another reason. And then also, I think that understanding how technology works will like help me to understand the world better. And also I find it really interesting and it fascinates me. So that's why I decided to study computer science. So to begin with, I'm gonna talk about like what we studied during the three terms at Drexel academically. So like the first term we had two computer science related classes. One was called CS 164, which is Introduction to Computer Science. So this was a lot of like theoretical aspects of computer science, and then towards the last few weeks of the term it was a lot of HTML and JavaScript that we had to do. There were a lot of projects, so I struggled with these projects because I'd never really coded HTML or JavaScript before. And then now, like looking back, I realize how easy it was after being a little experienced with JavaScript. So if you do end up studying computer science, don't let the first few weeks of doing it intimidate you. Give it some time and keep working hard at it. It mostly will get easier. The second class, in addition to the Introduction to Computer Science class, is a class called CI 101, which is basically, the full form is Computing and Informatics 101. It's called that because the school which has all these majors related to computer science at Drexel is called the College of Computing and Informatics, hence the name of the class. So this class is a little more like broad. It taught us a little bit about the software development process, a little bit about cybersecurity, and many other topics. It was a lot less technical compared to the other class, but it still had substantial material, but it wasn't that much of a time commitment. I actually really enjoyed it. Like, it taught me many things in a short amount of time. So during the second term at Drexel, we again had two classes related to computer science. These were kind of continuations of the two classes from the first term. So one of them was called CS 171, which is Introduction to Programming. This class taught us the basics of Python. It was an introduction to the language. The format was basically, there were lectures, there was labs, there was homework assignments, and then there were like a midterm exam and there was a final exam. I really liked this class because it taught me a lot about programming, and like it greatly improved my problem solving skills. It like taught me that you have to be patient and take time to code, and that's what I really liked about the class. Besides this, the other class was called CI 102. This was a little different from the class in the first term in the sense that this was more of a project based class where you were put in a team of 4 to 5 people and you had to design an app, website, or any like web technology that you wanted to do. So now coming to the third term, there was CS 172, which was Introduction to Programming Part 2, I think. This was again Python, but it was a little more advanced. Like, they taught us about object-oriented programming. They taught us a little bit about data structures. I like this class too. The professors were really helpful. Then we also had another continuation to the previous class, CI 103. So this was connected to CI 102 in the sense that we had to actually execute the app or the website that we designed in CI 102. This was one of my favorite and least favorite class at the same time that I've done during the first year at Drexel. It was my favorite class because I got to learn a lot, because I actually did a real life website. And it was my least favorite class because there were so many bugs that came up in the process, and it was a really frustrating process. But in the end, it was really rewarding. So what my group did was it was like a pretty basic app. We just created a pretty basic website. We created a website that like allowed users to store their blood pressure and sugar daily. So what made this interesting for me was that we actually used a database, and this was my first time doing so, which is why I really liked it, even though it was super frustrating. Okay, so that was a lot about the structure of the first year at Drexel academically. So besides that, I want to talk about the professors. I thought that the professors at Drexel were really good, and they were always ready to help. Besides the professors, they have teachers' assistants who were students, but they were in like their second, third, fourth, fifth year. These students were, again, amazingly, like, they were amazing. They helped so much. That's one thing that I really liked at Drexel. Besides that, I also found that there was a really collaborative environment, especially in computer science. Like, everyone was always ready to help each other and, like, work together to solve problems. Not, like, give each other the answers, but actually, like, sit down together and, like, if I have a question, I could ask someone. And, yeah, no one wanted to, like, hide information. It was really cool. Like, I made many of my best friends at Drexel through like, computer science. Now, coming to the activities that you can do related to computer science, Drexel has several clubs that are, like, filled with computer science majors. Like, there's a blockchain club, there's a cybersecurity club, there's a competitive coding club, there's an algorithms club. So there's several clubs that you can take part in. And besides these clubs, there's also a lot of hackathons in Philadelphia and around Philadelphia which you can attend, which I highly encourage. I went for a few hackathons myself, and I really enjoyed them because you get to learn, like, you like increase your like knowledge about programming drastically in just a matter of like 24 hours or 48 hours. So that's one of the biggest benefit of them. And you also get to like meet a lot of new people. So definitely do that if you go to Drexel or anywhere. If you are looking at like applying to Drexel, or if you're going to Drexel, Drexel is famous for its co-op program, which like allows you to gain work experience while studying. So basically, you like work for a few months, then you study for a few months, then you work for a few months. So how it works at Drexel is that the first year you're in school, and then you get a summer off, and then you have 6 months of work, 6 months of school, 6 months of work, 6 months of school, 6 months of work, 6 months of school. And then it's a 5-year program instead of 4 years. I mean, it's 5 years if you decide to do 3 co-ops, which gives you 18 months of work experience, or it's 4 years if you decide to do 1 co-op, which is 6 months of work experience. So I'm in the 5-year program. So my co-op is going to be coming up in September. So why I'm mentioning this is that the co-op is really beneficial. I mean, I haven't done it yet, but I'm interviewing with different companies at the moment, but the co-op is really beneficial because you actually get like real life programming experience while you're in college, so you can like relate what you're learning to the real world. Overall, I've really liked studying at Drexel, even though it's been only a year, but I've enjoyed whatever I've done. And if you do have any questions about Drexel, do email me and I'll get back to you. Please tell me what you liked and didn't like about this video in the comments below. And don't forget to like and subscribe. Thanks for watching.